Hi guys, a very good morning to all of you. So this is your Morning Tales video for February 11. And in this video, we will be discussing a lot of interesting and important questions for your RBI Grade B 2021 examination. So let's begin this video. But those who are coming for the first time, guys, you can subscribe to our channel and hit this bell notification so that you don't miss out on the important uploads that we make on our channel. So this reminds me that yesterday only I conducted the session on static GK. So if you have not watched that session, then do watch it in order to revise your static GK for the upcoming RBI Grade B examination. And the link will be provided to you in the description below. Now here is the Telegram group which you can join in order to get your queries resolved. And also here we provide you with the free quizzes. So if you want to attempt free quizzes, then you can join this group, and in case if you have any query, then also you can ask from your mentors directly on this group. So guys, before beginning this video, let me inform you that we have the crash course, and this crash course, after availing the 40% discount that we are offering on this crash course, this will be around 9,000 for you guys. So if you are preparing for the upcoming RBI examination, then you can go for this course. This will surely help you in grasping the entire course in a limited period of time. So if you really want to appear for the examination, then you can subscribe to this course by using this this coupon code CRASH40. Don't forget to use this code, otherwise you will not get the benefit of discount. So this is the code. Okay, so now let's begin our video for today with the first question. What is the theme of National Horticulture Fair 2021? So we have for Startup and Stand Up India, Inclusive Horticulture in the Wake of COVID-19, Stand Up for a Sustainable Horticulture Development, Indian Horticulture Rising Opportunities, AI for Indian Horticulture. So these are the five themes. Which one is the right theme? The right theme is option A for Startup and Stand Up India. So this is the 2021 edition of this fair, which was organized by Indian Institute of Horticulture Research. And guys, this institute is affiliated with the ICAR, that is Indian Council of Agriculture Research. So this is the affiliated institution of ICAR, Indian Institute of Horticulture Research. Now why is it so important for us to remember this thing? The reason behind this is that this fair was organized at the venue, at the premises of this institution. Now where is the premises of this institution located? It is in Bangalore. So do remember this thing. Bangalore is the place where this institute is located, and at this institute this fair was organized in a mixed manner, in the virtual as well as physical mode. Now we have discussed everything related to this fair. Let's discuss the events or activities that took place during this fair. So during this fair, this institution signed 4 MOUs with different countries, you know, companies, remember this thing, not countries. So 4 companies in order to commercialize its technology. Now what will it gain after commercializing its technology? The institution will help the horticulture farmers to grow more by commercializing its technology, and that is why 4 MOUs with different companies were signed by this organization. So that was one update during one activity that was held during this fair. Another activity was the announcement of chili hybrid variant. So this Indian Institute of Horticulture Research has developed a new variant of chilies, that is chili hybrid, in order to prevent or protect the chilies from the leaf curl virus. So this is the disease that affects the chilies the most. So this is one of the most destructive diseases for the chilies, and a question can be made on this, like Leaf curl disease is the most destructive disease for which of the following spices or for which of the following crops? So since this was announced during this National Horticulture Fair 2021 that is held in February only, this is very important for you to know or remember that this disease relates to this chilies. Okay, and in order to prevent chilies from this disease, this hybrid version of this of the chilies have been developed by Indian Institute of Horticulture Research. So guys, these were some of the updates related to this fair. Now my question from you is that who is the director of this institution? So this is your question. I hope that you won't forget to mention your answers in the comment section below. Now let's discuss the second question. With which North African country has India recently signed launched its business council? So we have Algeria, Morocco, Libya, Egypt and Tunisia. All these five countries belong to the North African region. Now with which country has India established its business council? So the right answer is Tunisia. It's India-Tunisia Business Council that has been recently launched during the India-Tunisia Economic Council, Economic Dialogue that was organized by the Indian organization by India. So that is all for this question, because there is nothing much that we should remember from the exam point of view apart from this fact that it is with Tunisia that this this business council has been established. And what is the purpose of this business council? Very clear. The purpose is to promote trade and tourism between India and Tunisia. And remember that Tunisia is one of the most important countries for India in terms of trade. And in order to promote that trade, this business council has been established. Now, what is the capital and what is the currency of Tunisia? This is your question for the day that you are going to tell me. Okay. Which of the following company has created India's first ever diesel turned CNG tractor? So this is a very basic question. I don't think that there is any fact that we can discuss here apart from this fact that this tractor is owned by the Union Minister of Road Transport and Highways, that is Nitin Gadkari. So the tractor of Nitin Gadkari was a diesel tractor which has been turned into the CNG tractor by using technological advancements. Now, which company has transformed this diesel tractor into CNG tractor? So, the right answer is option B. That is Romet Techno Solutions and Tomisato Ekai India. So, these are the two companies that collaboratively converted this diesel tractor into CNG tractor. Apart from this, there is nothing, guys, that you can remember from this news. Therefore, we are quickly moving on to our next question. With which payment bank has Confederation of Real Estate Developers Association of India signed an MOU to facilitate opening of bank accounts for construction workers? So this organization, abbreviated as CREDAI, so this organization works for the real estate. Sorry, this is the apex body for real estate developers. Now, this organization has signed an MOU with one of the payment banks from the options in order to increase the financial inclusion or enhance the scope of financial inclusion among the construction workers. So that is the basic purpose of this MOU, to increase the financial awareness as well as financial literacy among the construction workers. This MOU has been signed apart from opening the bank accounts for construction workers. So this is something that will be done under this MOU. Now let's discuss with which payment bank has this MOU been signed. We have Jio Payment Bank, India Post Payment Banks, NSDL Payment Bank, Fino Payment Bank and Paytm Payments Bank. So here the right answer is option D. It's India Post Payment Bank with which this MOU has been signed. And who is the MD and CEO of this bank? This is your question that you are going to tell me in the comment section below. Now we have the next question. Who has been appointed as the CEO and MD of Tata motors. So you have five options: Philip Goson, Mark Listocella, Gunapati Venkata Krishna Reddy, Garo H. Armin, and Lisa Su. Who is the person that has been appointed? It's option B, Mark Listocella. Remember his name, it's a very recent appointment, can be asked in the examination. So CEO and MD of Tata Motors. So that's all for this question. Now we are moving on to our next question, which is the one of the most important questions of today's session. So do listen to me very carefully. Who among the following is a winner of SERB Women Excellence Award 2021? First of all, what does SERB stand for? It's Science and Engineering Research Board. This is the full form of SERB. So clearly from the full form of SERB, now it is clear that this Women Excellence Award is given in the field of Science and Engineering. The people who perform well in the Science and Engineering field, they are given this one-time award, Women Excellence Award. Why did I use the word one time? The reason behind this is that this is a one-time award given to a person who is below 40 years. So 40 years is the eligibility limit. And since this award is given by a government organization, therefore the eligibility limit is also important. 40 years is the threshold for giving this, for becoming eligible for this award. So the women who are below 40 years and who have achieved some kind of accolade or recognition from national academies are eligible for this Women Excellence Award in the field of Science and Engineering. Now, for the year 2021, the awards have been given and four women have been awarded. Now, who are these four women? They are right in front of you. First one is Shobana Kapoor, second is Antara Banerjee, third one is Sonu Gandhi, and fourth one is Ritu Gupta. So the right answer is option E, all of the above. SERB Women Excellence Award 2021 has been given to four women, and these are the names of all the four women. Now this question ends, but there is something attached to this question that we should pay our attention to, and that is that this award was given on a very special day, and that day is International Day for Women and Girls in Science, and it is celebrated in February 11. So it is celebrated by UN on February 11. What is the theme? Women and women scientists at the forefront of fight against COVID-19. So I hope that this theme is clear to you. Let me write it down for you guys. Women scientists at the forefront of fight against COVID-19. This is the theme for 2021. And remember that this SERB Women Excellence Award was given on this day, International Day for Women and Girls in Science, observed by United Nations. The theme is this, and the date is February 11. So here, all the information related to this question ends along with this session. So I hope that you have enjoyed this session, and if you have, then do share it with your friends. Thank you so much for watching this session.